Reverend Dr. Austin Eghaghe, the voice of power, revival and correction, too loaded to be ignored.
I like to cancel the present day government of this land and to cancel my country. First of all, I sympathize with these states, sympathize with this country, because I know we are making a lot of losses because there are no more revenues coming from all the appropriate places due to this lockdown and this pandemic that is plaguing our land. But however, I also have counselor. If you look at the Bible very well, you will discover that Joseph was not a professor of economics, but God gave him the solution that could cure the earth from famine for the space of 7 years in the Bible. Moses was not a medical doctor, but God gave him the cure, how he turned that bitter water into sweet water, and the people were healed. Even in Numbers chapter 21 from verse 1 to 4, he was not a scientist. God showed Moses what he must do in order to avoid the plague when the fiery snake began to bite people. So they were also healed. Revelation chapter 22 verse 2. The leaves of the tree was for the healings of the nation. Ezekiel chapter 47 verse 12. Leaves thereof for medicine. That is what the word of God says. Now I want us to understand that there is no problem that has been, that is, or that will ever be, that God have not provided solution for. That's why we pastors always say there is no problem without solution. God has provided the solution even before the problem. Let another 1 million virus appear in this world, the solution is already provided for. All we need to do is that God should open our eyes to know where the solution is situated. Now that we know that leaves carries the solution, if you look at the statistical reports, the records from the WHO, World Health Organization, on Google, countries that are not synthetic, they've been able to overcome this coronavirus. Synthetic countries like America, Spain, Italy, UK, Russia, those synthetic countries that have gone far in technology, in development, in civilization, they have gone too far away from the leaves. They are dying because they are distant away from the leaves. But look at countries that are not synthetic. They don't have money. They don't have enough civilization and development. Their names are not ringing bell in the world. What is happening? If you look at their statistics, you will discover that they have been able to conquer coronavirus. Now, my question now is this: is coronavirus different from this world or to the other part of the world? If coronavirus is the same, then what we need to do is to approach it holistically, how we can quickly release our people from this lockdown. In Psalm 41, verse 1, it says, "He that considereth the poor, the Lord shall deliver him." He that consider. Now, to consider the poor means to put yourself into their shoes. There are women in this town having 9 children, 8 children, without any husband. It's what they've gathered a day that keeps them moving. Now, to deny them from going to their store, stay at home, and so on, and if the days are prolonged, their patience will be exhausted. That is my point. Let us consider some of these countries that have been able to conquer coronavirus. On the 4th of May, I got this report through Google. Example is a country called Brunei. Brunei has 138 people infected. 130 have recovered. Only one died. Maybe at that time they have not discovered the secret. Another country called Cambodia. Cambodia has 122 people infected. Nobody has been infected for the past 1 week plus. And 120 of them have recovered and gone home, and nobody died. Now, we know that Cambodia is not a synthetic country. It's not a popular country. It's not a rich country per se, like America, like UK. They cannot be compared to all those other synthetic countries, like Germany. But they've been able to overcome this coronavirus because they are closer to the leaves than those who are closer to orthodox drugs. Now, Madagascar. Madagascar, as at 1 week ago, on the 4th of May 2020, they have 151 people infected, 99 discharged to go home, and nobody died. Now, what about a country called Fore Island? Fore Island is an unpopular country. It's a village country. So they resorted to their local traditional medication system. And what's the result? They have 187 people affected, 185 have been discharged to go home, and nobody died. What about a country like Rwanda? Rwanda is very close to us here in Africa. Rwanda is not a rich country because of the war that they fought many years ago. So the country dilapidated to an extent that they are just struggling to exist. We all know that Nigeria is far better than Rwanda. They have 261 cases, 128 have been discharged, and nobody died. Now, what about a country like Vietnam? Vietnam has 271 cases, why 232 have been discharged to go home and nobody died. What about a country like Gibraltar? Gibraltar has 144 cases, why 133 have been discharged to go home. Maybe about 10 or 11 are just still there in the hospital. Nobody died. What about a country like Uganda? Uganda is in Africa. We know Uganda very well. That Uganda is a very, very poor country. But what happened? They have 97 cases, 55 have been discharged to go home, and nobody died. We have a country called French Polynesia. French Polynesia, they have 58 people infected, 51 have been discharged to go home, and nobody died. All these are village countries, they are not synthetic countries, they are not rich countries. But they resorted to their local traditional medical system, and they are okay. The system is working right now. Transportation is moving. Education, people are going to school. Everything is working in their society. There is no lockdown anywhere, and it's helping them. What about a country called St. Lucia? Some of you may just be hearing these countries for the first time, only to hear their names. They are not known in any other. They are not popular. They are not rich, but they've been able to conquer this virus. And that's my point. St. Lucia has 18 people infected, 15 have been discharged to go home, and nobody died. Now my point is this. President can talk to president, governor can talk to governors. It's as simple as this. Today communication is very easy. There are video calls, there are phone calls. If you do not have the phone number of the governor, if you do not have the phone number of the president, you can call somebody who can connect you to the phone. And when they introduce who is calling, they will know that it's a personality calling. Say, please, what did you people apply that gave you victory over coronavirus? And when you are told, we also apply it here in order to save our society, it's just a little point. I want us to consider this. Because of the poor among us, not because we are hungry, not because we are suffering, but we should think. The Bible says, he that considereth, in Proverbs chapter 29, he that considereth the cause of the poor, even God himself, will also deliver him when his own time comes. There are poor people in our society. We cannot overlook their plight at this point in time. Let us quickly do the needful and release them from this stay at home so they can go back to their normal lives and sustain their families like before. My name is Austin Eghaghe. I just want to make a reasonable point. Thank you.